A spectacular new NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope image, one of the largest ever released of a star-forming region, highlights N11, part of a complex network of gas clouds and star clusters within our neighboring galaxy, the Large Magellanic Cloud. This region of energetic star formation is one of the most active in the nearby universe. The Large Magellanic Cloud, or LMC, contains many bright bubbles of glowing gas. One of the largest and most spectacular has the name LHA-120N11, from its listing in a catalogue compiled by the American astronomer and astronaut Carl Henneis in 1956, and is informally known as N11. Close up, the billowing pink clouds of glowing gas make N11 resemble a puffy swirl of fairground candy floss. From further away, its distinctive overall shape led some observers to nickname it the Bean Nebula. The dramatic and colorful features visible in the nebula are the telltale signs of star formation. N11 is a well-studied region that extends over 1,000 light-years. It is the second largest star-forming region within the LMC and has produced some of the most massive stars known. It is the process of star formation that gives N11 its distinctive look. Three successive generations of stars, each of which formed further away from the center of the nebula than the last, have created shells of gas and dust. These shells were blown away from the newborn stars in the turmoil of their energetic birth and early life, creating the ring shape so prominent in this image. Beans are not the only terrestrial shapes to be found in the spectacular high-resolution image from the NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope. In the upper left is the red bloom of the Rose Nebula N11A. Its petals of gas and dust are illuminated from within, thanks to the radiation from the massive hot stars at its center. The Rose Nebula is relatively compact and dense and is the site of the most recent burst of star development in the region. Other star clusters abound in N11, including NGC 1761 at the bottom of the image, which is a group of massive hot young stars busily pouring intense ultraviolet radiation out into space. Although it is much smaller than our own galaxy, the LMC is a very vigorous region of star formation. Studying these stellar nurseries helps astronomers understand a lot more about how stars are born and their ultimate development and lifespan. Both the LMC and its small companion, the Small Magellanic Cloud, are easily seen with the unaided eye and have always been familiar to people living in the Southern Hemisphere.
The NASA ESA Hubble Space Telescope celebrates its 17th birthday with one of the largest panoramic images ever taken, the violent stellar fireworks of the Carinae Nebula. In the southern sky, not far from the Southern Cross, we find the constellation Carinae, the Keel. Here, 8,000 light-years away, the immense Carinae Nebula is located. Hubble's new view of the Carinae Nebula shows the process of starbirth at a new level of detail. The bizarre landscape of the nebula is sculpted by the action of outflowing winds and scorching ultraviolet radiation from the monster stars that inhabit this inferno. In the center of the nebula, we find Eta Carinae, which is estimated to be 100 times more massive than our Sun. It is in the final stages of its brief eruptive lifespan, as shown by two billowing lobes of gas and dust that presage its forthcoming explosion as a titanic supernova. Eta Carinae was the site of a giant outburst about 150 years ago, when it temporarily became one of the brightest stars in the southern sky. The star remains one of the great mysteries of stellar astronomy.
Looking closer at the nebula, we find a number of very interesting features. Pillars of gas and dust reveal unequivocal evidence that stars are being born inside the columns. Streamers of gas shoot out from the pillars and plow into the surrounding gas, like a fire hose hitting a wall of sand. The jets are being launched from newly forming stars hidden inside the columns. Everywhere we find small nuggets of cold molecular hydrogen and dust, called Bok globules, that are silhouetted against the nebula. Now, the edges are glowing, which indicates that they're being irradiated by the hotter stars around. It's been hypothesized that stars may be forming inside these dusty cocoons.
Orion the Hunter is one of the most striking constellations in the sky, and is a familiar sight to amateur and professional astronomers alike. The Orion Nebula is faintly visible to the naked eye as a dim glow in the Hunter's sword. This swirling cloud of gas and dust is 1500 light-years from Earth and has fascinated astronomers since the earliest days of the telescope. Appearing to the eye as a small cluster of blue-white stars surrounded by a mysterious mist, the nebula's vast dusty regions have long hidden from human eyes an enormous stellar nursery full of young, hot stars. The Visible and Infrared Survey Telescope for Astronomy, or VISTA, has taken a spectacular new image that reveals some of the nebula's buried secrets. VISTA is the latest addition to ESO's Paranal Observatory in Chile, and it's the largest survey telescope in the world, with a mirror measuring 4.1 meters in diameter. It's dedicated to mapping the sky in the infrared part of the spectrum. By looking in the infrared instead of visible light, VISTA is able to peer straight through the obscuring gas and dust in the Orion Nebula. That's because in the infrared, at about twice the wavelength of visible light, the dust in the nebula turns largely transparent, giving us a clear view of the young stars that lie within. No other telescope has ever been able to not only see through the dust to reveal the hidden features buried within the Orion Nebula, but also to show its huge extent in amazing detail in a single image. At the very heart of the nebula lie the four brilliant stars forming the trapezium, a group of very hot young stars pumping out fierce ultraviolet radiation that is clearing the surrounding region and making the gas glow. Observing in the infrared also allows VISTA to reveal many other young stars in this central region that cannot be seen in visible light. In this dusty region of the nebula, gas jets shot out by young stars at around 700,000 kilometers an hour have collided with the surrounding gas and dust, exciting it and sculpting strange red shapes. Normally invisible, these curious wisps provide important clues for astronomers as they try to understand how stars are born and what happens in their early years.
Visible to the naked eye, only 1,500 light years from Earth, the Great Orion Nebula has been known and revered since ancient times. A popular target of Hubble, researchers have now identified 42 new disks within it that could be the beginnings of new planetary systems like our own.
In the sword, just under the belt in the constellation of Orion the Hunter, is the majestic Orion Nebula. The Orion Nebula is one of the best-known examples of a star-forming nebula, a swirling cloud of gas and dust where stars begin their journey of life. Now, in the early 1990s, astronomers discovered so-called proplyds in Orion using Hubble. A proplyd is a proto-planetary disk, and it forms along with a newborn star in a spinning mixture of gas and dust. At the center, you have the star forming, and around it, bits of dust clump together to form a disk. Essentially, proplyds are thought to be young planetary systems in the making.
One of the first targets of astronomers after telescopes were invented in the 17th century, the Orion Nebula was also the first nebula ever photographed, over 100 years ago by the American astronomer Henry Draper, a pioneer in astrophotography. His photograph, taken in 1880, represents a milestone in the history of astronomy.
Now, the beauty of the Orion Nebula is not its only draw. Astronomers are interested in it because it is one of the nearest star-forming regions to Earth, with stars that are massive enough to heat up the surrounding gas, making it glow. This fascinating object has been a favorite target of Hubble's from very early on in the observatory's lifetime. The sharpest image ever taken of the Orion Nebula was released in 2006. This image from Hubble's advanced camera for surveys shows more than 3,000 stars of various sizes, some of which had never before been seen in visible light. Now, looking at the frenzied mixture of gas and swirling dust, it's pretty clear that a lot is going on inside the Orion Nebula.
Within the awe-inspiring gaseous folds of Orion, researchers, using data from the Wide Field Channel on Hubble's Advanced Camera for Surveys, have identified two different types of disks. The ones that lie close to the brightest star in the cluster, Theta 1 Orionis C, and those farther away from it. The star affects the nearby disks by heating up the gas within them, causing them to shine brightly. The excited material produces many glowing cusps, which all face the bright star and are thus randomly oriented within the nebula. Other interesting features enhance the looks of these captivating objects, such as jets of matter flowing away and shockwaves. The dramatic shockwaves are formed when the stellar wind from the nearby massive star meets the gas in the nebula, producing interesting shapes. They sometimes appear like boomerangs or arrows, and in the case of 181825, the shockwave makes appropriate looks like a space jellyfish.
The disks that are farther away do not receive enough energetic radiation from the star to set the gas ablaze. That's why these disks can only be detected as a dark silhouette against the bright background of the nebula. The dust in the disk simply absorbs the light from the background. It is in these silhouette disks that astronomers are better able to study the properties of dust grains, which are thought to clump together and possibly form planets like our own.
The bright star that illuminates some of the Proplyds, allowing us to see them, is both a blessing and a curse. The powerful radiation that lights them up also threatens their very existence, as the disk material, once heated up, is very likely to dissipate and dissolve, destroying their potential to become planets. Some of the bright Proplyds are doomed to be torn apart, but others will survive and perhaps evolve into planetary systems.
It is relatively rare to see images of Proplyds in visible light. However, the resolution and sensitivity of Hubble, combined with the Orion Nebula's proximity to Earth, allow for an excellent view of these fascinating objects. Although Proplyds may appear to be only humble smudges, some of them are in fact the seeds of solar systems to come.